The office of the Prime Minister has been hit by several corruption scandals, with the latest being the Iron Sheet saga. Chris Bariomwasi, the Minister for ICT and Information, says the problem might be partly due to lack of supervision, given the fact that the office of the Prime Minister is too massive and contains many departments. He says this makes it hard for just one person to supervise it.
Because like it has Ministry for Relief and Disaster Preparedness, which is a full-fledged ministry, but under office of Prime Minister, and the whole ministry for general duties. Then you have these affirmative programs, the Ministry for Karamoja, which is a full-fledged ministry. Then the Well Triangle, you have Teso Affairs, Bunyoro Affairs, Northern Uganda. So I think it is huge. Maybe.
Bariomwasi says the government should consider restructuring OPM so some departments can run independently.
Government needs to look at how you could restructure the whole office of Prime Minister and probably separate implementation from coordination and monitoring, because they are all fused into one structure. Maybe that could be part of the problem.
He also expressed concern over the manner in which ministers implicated in the Iron Sheet scandal are being arrested. He advised the police to carry out arrests with some dignity.
Dr. Chris Bariomwasi, we want you at the police station ABCD, and I will drive there. And if I have a file which is ready, you can even alert me, said, because the ministers know they are being investigated. Why wouldn't the police say, and your file is ready, we shall be proceeding to court? I don't think any minister would go into hiding. He would drive there and then you go to court.
The minister also made it clear that the ongoing investigations have not affected the performance of cabinet in any way. He said, besides, the law does not call for implicated ministers to step down for investigations to be carried out.
Civil service, even when you are charged in the courts of law, you are interdicted. So that you step aside as the court process moves on until when you are cleared or convicted. Now the law and the regulations, I think, are silent on the case of political leaders. So I think one has to take personal responsibility over it.
Report by Jaliet Namuwaya for the news.